welcome to New Jersey's Child Care Assistance Program. In New Jersey, we use eChildCare. eChildCare is an electronic time and attendance system. With eChildCare, parents are required to check their children in and out of care daily. You check your children in and out of care daily by either using a point of service device or the telephone. This is how your provider will get paid. All parents who receive child care assistance benefits and all providers who accept child care assistance are required to use eChildCare. In this video, we will show you how to use the eChildCare system and the importance of checking your child in and out of care each day. Mrs. Gabriel is dropping off little Danny. Let's watch as she checks him into care. As you can see, she goes to the swipe machine to complete the check-in process and then signs him in. Once you get used to it, this entire process takes about 2 minutes and needs to be done every day the child is in care. Now let's talk about how eChildCare works. All families will be issued a family's first card, which is very similar to a debit or credit card. If you do not already have a card, you will receive a family's first card in the mail from Xerox. The family's first card can be used with either the swipe machine, which most child care centers use, or the automated phone system used by all in-home providers, as well as some centers. If your provider uses the phone, you must call in from the phone that is registered for eChildCare at the provider's location. You cannot call in from just any phone. Whether you use the swipe machine or phone, you must check your child in and out every day so your provider can get paid. Let's talk a little bit about your family's first card. You and two designees, those would be people you identify to drop off or pick up your child, can each have a family's first card. You cannot select your child care provider or anyone acting on the child care provider's behalf as your designee. You will need to activate your card to use it for child care benefits, even if you currently use the card for SNAP, food stamp benefits, or welfare benefits. To do so, you need to select a personal identification number, also known as a PIN, by calling 1-800-997-3333. You will be connected to an automated phone system that will tell you to select a language and enter 2 for childcare. Enter the 16-digit number on your family's first card. Then enter your birth date and any 4-digit number you choose as your PIN number. Once that is done, your card is active and ready for use. If you already have a family's first card, you must have your card linked by calling your local Child Care Resource and Referral Agency, or the CCRNR. This linking is done for both swipe machine and telephone users. If you haven't had your benefits linked yet, you will need to call your CCRNR office immediately to have that done. If you receive other benefits on your family's first card besides child care, the card for your designee won't allow them to access your SNAP or welfare benefits. Their card is for child care only. Remember, you access your child care benefits by using this card. For security reasons, you want to protect it as you would your credit or bank card. And one more note about your family's first card. Don't leave the card with your provider. If you do, you can lose your assistance. Now that you know how to activate and link your family's first card, let's talk about using your card. Let's start with the happy path when everything in your day goes smoothly. There are 4 common eChildCare transactions that you will use regularly. Check-in, check-out, previous check-in, and previous check-out. It is important to know how to do each one. Mom comes in with little Danny in the morning. She's at a center that has a swipe machine. She'll swipe her card and enter her PIN. The machine will present her with a menu. She'll select check-in. That will prompt her for a child number. When you receive your card, you will also be given a child number. This is a 2-digit number, 01, 02, and so on, for as many children as are associated with that case. So in this case, little Danny is the only child in care. Mom will type in 01. It will ask her if she has any more children to check in. No, just Danny. She'll hit enter. Mom is done. A receipt that says approved will print out. At the end of the day, Mom will come back, collect little Danny, and swipe the card, enter the PIN, hit checkout, child 01, and enter. Again, you should get a receipt that says approved. So, that's the way eChildCare works when everything goes smoothly. Now let's talk about when everything does not go as planned. In the morning, we have the same scenario. Mom comes in, checks in little Danny with no problem. That afternoon, Mom comes to pick up Danny. She says, "Listen, I got a problem at home. I gotta go. Can I catch you tomorrow?" and off she goes. She comes in the next morning and attempts to check little Danny in. She's going to get a denied message, and the denial will be check-in exists, because she checked in little Danny yesterday in the morning, but she never checked him out. But don't worry, the fix for missed days can be done in the back swipe period. The back swipe period is a 14-day window so you can get caught up on all missing transactions. In other words, you can go back 13 previous days from the current day to enter any missed days. Mom now needs to do a previous checkout transaction, which is similar to a check-in. To begin the process, she will always start by swiping the card, entering the 4-digit PIN and the 2-digit child number. Let's watch Mrs. Gabriel. On the menu, she will select previous checkout because Danny was not checked out yesterday. The next step is to enter the missing date and the departure time. And that's it. Now that the previous checkout is complete, Mrs. Gabriel can do a regular check-in. Now for the last common transaction. Let's talk about when to use the previous check-in. The previous check-in transaction is used when you forget to check in your child. Let's say mom comes to pick up Danny in the afternoon after forgetting to check him in that morning. She swipes and attempts to check him out. She's going to get an error message, check-in not found. Why? Because she never checked little Danny in that morning. Now let's fix it. Swipe again and enter the PIN and child number. Now on the menu, select previous check-in. Enter the date and time of arrival. Now mom is ready to do a regular checkout. The previous check-in or checkout process that we just discussed also can be done for after school care. Little Lauren goes to after school care at 3:15 after her school day, but mom doesn't pick her up until 6 o'clock. When mom comes in, she is going to do a previous check-in at 3:15 and then a regular checkout. Let's look at a before and after school scenario. Little Lauren may arrive at childcare first thing in the morning at 7 a.m. She goes to school at 9. She comes back to childcare at 3. But mom doesn't pick her up until 6 p.m. So mom checks her in at 7 a.m. and checks her out at 6 p.m. There is no need to do the 4 swipes in and out, in and out. Here's what's important to know about the previous check-in and previous checkout features. The previous check-in or checkout features are used when you missed a check-in or checkout. It doesn't matter if you've missed check-in or checkouts that day, yesterday, or one day last week. You can catch up during the back swipe period, which allows you to go back 13 previous missed days plus today's date for a total of 14 days. When you miss a check-in or out, don't wait, catch up right away. It will be much easier that way. Also remember, you have up to 2 designees that can check your child in or out when you can't make it in. Just a note about what happens when your child is sick. You can report a sick day from any phone, even if your provider uses a swipe machine, or you can report it during the back swipe period when your child returns to care. We've just talked about the 4 transactions you'll use most with each child care: check-in, check-out, previous check-in, and previous check-out. Now that you've mastered these 4 transactions, this will become a part of your daily routine.
There's a few tips that I use that I think will be helpful to you too. First, give yourself some extra time dropping off and picking up your child when you are learning the e-childcare system. Why put unnecessary pressure on yourself if you don't need to? Second, if your transactions are being denied, tell your childcare provider the first time it happens. Don't ignore it or wait until you're having the problem for many days. Tell them right away. Third, if you use a swipe machine, save the receipts. I have an envelope in my purse and I tuck the receipts in there. But you could put a receipt envelope in your car, briefcase, anywhere that's convenient. If you need to use the back swipe process, the receipt will help you figure out the date of your last accepted transaction. I'll be honest, I was a little nervous about learning how to use e-childcare. But once I got used to it, I checked my children in and out of care very quickly. My advice to you, parent of parent, is stay current with your check-in and check-outs. It's when you get behind that it gets complicated and it takes longer. Trust me when I tell you that the mother behind you in line will be so much happier if you keep your transactions current.
Now e-childcare is part of our family routine. Before long, it will become part of yours too.